Bande Guru Padadandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Pabham Bande Nitha Nanda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nanda Nanga Bande Radhika Charno Dayam Gopijano Samayuktam Binda Banam Manu Vāñśā kalpataru vāśya kipā sindh bevacha Patitānaṁ pāvune bhavaiṣṇa bebhyo namo namaha Mūkaṁ karoti vācālaṁ pangung langhaiti girin Yat kipātam haṁ vande paramānanda vādavam Vṛndāvai tulsidevvai piyāvai kesavasacha Krishna Bhakti Pade Devi Satya Vattvai Namo Namaha Narayana Namaskritta Naram Chaiva Narottamam Deving Swaraswating Vyasam Tato Jayo Deva Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadesha Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadhanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagod Varunu Deyam Sada Paribhavagna Mavishchuduham Tethas Padam Siva Virinjanutam Saranyam Bhitatiham Panutopal Bhavadibutam Bande Mahapurusate Charanaravindam Yat pada pallavana kachanna mani chatai Visvurji takimapikapavadushva darshi Purna nuragra sasagra saramurti Saradhikami kadakifam kroshi Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Ajanu lambita bhujau kanuka vadatu Sanketanai kavitaru kamalayataksho Vishambaru dijavaru jugadhar bapalau Bande yagat priyakaru karuna vadharu Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Namami Gange Tava Padupankajam Sura surair bandito dibbarupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavanurupe na sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayana Priyamananga Madapuharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavishanatham Vagisha Yasya Badane Lakshmir Yasacha Vakshasi Yasyasti Hide Sambhid Tvam Nishinga Maham Bhaji Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Nikhilo bhuvana maya chinna vichinna karti Vibhuda bahulo megyam mukti mahanta datri Shithilito vidiraga radha radhe shadhani Vilasatu hrida nityam bhakti siddhanta bani Nikhilo bhuvana maya chinna vichinna karti Vibhuda bahulo megyam mukti mahanta datri Shithilito vidiraga radha radhe shadhani Vilasatu hrida nityam bhakti siddhanta bani Gauriya Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagat Guru told, until and unless there is 100% Saranagati unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, one cannot speak about that absolute truth, absolute way. Gauriya Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagat Guru told, that until and unless you are 100% inclined unto the Saranagata, unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, until and unless one is 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, he cannot speak about that absolute truth, absolute way. It is impossible. Because each and every time when we are going to speak Harikatha, we fear. We are thinking about how to represent this philosophy Harikatha so that common people don't get disturbance. But actually, it is our duty on behalf of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasava, on behalf of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada and Bhakti Vinod Thakur, it is our duty to speak as it is. Prabhupada speaking, if we are going to change our, you know, darshan, if you are going to change our, you know, siddhanta, then all responsibility can come on us. In that case, Supreme Lord, I mean, Nityananda Balaram, not going to take any responsibility. If I am going to change my darshan, if I am going to change some little bit, in that case, all responsibility can come on my head. Prabhupada speaking, if you can speak about that absolute truth, absolute way, as per Sauta Pantha, you will have to speak exactly what it is there. If you are going to change something, then all responsibility, you will have to take all responsibility. Because, you know, our Harikatha, our Kirtan, is to satisfy, give full satisfaction to Supreme Lord. Kalau hari, kalau tad harikirtanat. Harikirtan harikatha, through harikirtan harikatha, we like to satisfy Supreme Lord 100%. It should be our duty, it should be our goal, it should be our motto or final. Actually, point is that Prabhupada speaking, just like a postman, any message coming in the letter, you cannot chase that postman. Postman going to deliver, deliver the letter to you. Any letter you are getting through post office, there a postman going to give delivery to this letter to you, to your hand. If you find some heavy news there, you cannot attack that postman. Because postman is not responsible, he is going to deliver it, give deliver to you. So, Prabhupada speaking, we are going to deliver all of Prakita Sauta Pantha, what all Siddhanta we are getting, we are going to deliver to you all, intact way. Intact way, we have no power to change anything, amendment, even any kirtan, Prabhupada speaking, even any kirtan, if you are going to change some dot, full stop, dot, punctuation, something, then meaning can change. Bonded soul cannot even add even single word. Because his material man is going to add something, it is offensive. So we have no right to change our, you know, what is there. Many big acharya, they have some contradiction over this issue. Big fighting going on. So actually those who are in Sauta Pantha, those big acharya, they're speaking. What is written there in Kirtan, Narottama Thakur Kirtan, or Bhaktivinoda Thakur Kirtan, any Kirtan anywhere. We cannot change any line in what to speak about life. Even the punctuation we cannot change. Then we will have to get punishment. Follow. So this way we have no right to change anything. So we are acting as a postman, give delivery letter to you all. That is our duty. Actually, we like to discuss about the unique acharyaship of Srila Prabhupada. Ever seen in the history of civilization, human civilization, ever seen. We like to discuss this point. At the same time, we like to discover how far we are deviated from the track of Prabhupada, from the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. At the same time, the focus point is that Vishva Vaishnava Rasva is total duty, a prakita duty on behalf of that. So you see, we like to discuss about the aprakita acharyaship, unique acharyaship of Srila Prabhupada. Long ago, that time Prabhupada was in Mayapur doing, and there was one big Dharma Sabha in Calcutta. And all our Gaudiya devotees, sannyasi, brahmachari, they are going to speak their Harikatha. And they are speaking Harikatha, and Siddha Sarup Prabhu. Siddha Sarup means, who is Siddhanti Maharaj. You are Siddhanti, Bhakti Surup Siddhanti Maharaj was there actually, Siddha Sarup Prabhu. And all other Maharaj also there. So in Harikatha, when Siddha Sarup Prabhu is speaking, because those who are Gaudiya Math devotee, you cannot understand the mood of their, you cannot understand their mood. What perfection is there inside their heart? Because whole world and 100%, yeah, almost 100%, maybe 0.00001% can be there. We can say almost 100% of the population here in this world, they are more or less busy to make some reconciliation with impersonalism. But Prabhupada speaking, if we are going to make slight compromise, point something, compromise with Shuddha Bhakti, we are going to make compromise with impersonalism, and we like to make some, reconciliation, Prabhupada speaking, that if we are slightly deviated from the track of Shuddha Bhakti, be sure ultimately we are going to jump into the lap of Maya. Impersonalism means ultimately we can prove that it is Maya, nothing else. Impersonalism means Maya, nothing else. I was discussing for a long time about how different way impersonalism can come in my life. Countless different way can come in my life to contaminate my heart so that I can take leave from pure devotion. Pure devotional feeling. Actually, Siddha Sarup Prabhu going to speak Harikatha, really so. Speaking Harikatha, in the meantime, is speaking to cut Mayavad Siddhanta, is speaking that preacher from Mayavadi, XY mission, is actually big hooligan, gunda. I'm not going to speak the name of that, mission. Siddha Sarup Prabhu speaking, that preacher from that Mayavad society, mission, is a hooligan. In the name of, in the field of, dharma, in dharma jagatir gunda, He is a hooligan of this, you know, spiritual world. Also, many times I told before, the mafia, different kind of mafia, in political field, in educational field, in sports field, where not, even in spiritual field, we can find, discover, if your eyes is clear, open, then you can, if you are blind, then you cannot see. Because anyway, you are busy with Mayavad Vichar, so you cannot understand. So, they are actually mafia, spiritual mafia. So, same thing, Siddha Swarupa Prabhu wanted to speak, but there was a big problem in the society, in that sabha. Everybody shouting actually, Siddha Swarupa Prabhu very strictly, you know, started giving answer why he was bound to speak that way. Still there was problem. And immediately news came to Prabhupada that Siddha Swarupa Prabhu speaking this way, in front of open public, this way, heavily. Prabhupada smiling and speaking. Actually, he is speaking rightly. Nobody can speak that way. That kind of spirit is not there with everybody. Right? He's speaking very nicely. Now you can understand the spirit of Srila Prabhupada. Acharya of Srila Prabhupada. You try to understand. Long ago, again, another sabha, two or three examples if I am giving, then you can understand this point. Because the Acharya Siva Prabhupada is really unique. Nobody can understand properly what he mean to say. Actually, long ago, there was one Dharma Sabha in Calcutta, same in Calcutta, not same place, different place. There was Parampuja Keshav Goswami Maharaj and Parampuja Sridhar Goswami Maharaj and so many devotees, so many Gaudiya sannyasis were there to speak Harikatha. And now Parampuja Keshav Goswami Maharaj is going to speak. And in the beginning, Parampuja Keshav Goswami Maharaj, in the starting of Harikatha, Keshav Goswami Maharaj speaking, what I can say in front of those, leather men, এই চামার গুলোর সামনে আমি কি হরিকথা বলবো? What হরিকথা I can speak in front of those leather men? They are actually chamar, leather men. They are busy with skin, really so. Material, those who are this material society, they are busy with their profit, material profit and loss. Naturally, they are busy with their skin, a skin related thing. Body and body related thing, mind and material mind and mind related thing, they are busy. So it's appropriate, very right, 100%. But there was a big evolution. Why you are speaking this way? Why you are speaking this way? You will have to give answer. Why you are speaking this way? Then there was big agitation. Then there was Sridhar Goswami, Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami Maharaj was a big lawyer, big lawyer. He is speaking, stand up and started speaking. Wait. Just a minute, wait. You will have to give answer. We all, audience speaking, we all like to get answer. Why is speaking so this way? We like to get answer. Then the all public speaking. Yes, we like to get answer. We like to get answer. Why is speaking that way? If he cannot give us a satisfactory answer, then we can see what a man he is like. Eh? Then, Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami Maharaj giving chance. Now you will have to explain why you are speaking this way. Eh? Go on speaking. Then Sridhar Goswami Maharaj giving chance. And then Paramahansa Keshav Goswami Maharaj started speaking. Why I am speaking? Why I am bound to speak that way? After the Harikatha is over, everybody is silent. Nobody can speak anything. Because it is right. Paramahansa Keshav Goswami Maharaj was bound to prove that way. Because absolute truth, we cannot pass away absolute truth. One big Maharaj of one big mutt invite Paramahansa Keshav Goswami Maharaj, another incident I am speaking, to speak Harikatha in the symposium there. Okay, I am not going to speak the name of that mot because I am not going to criticize anybody. only we like to understand the mood of Srila Prabhupada. And they, you know, naturally Kesava Goswami also having the same mood of Prabhupada. So Kesava Goswami Maharaj and some of his disciples, they reached that moth, and in the evening time started Harikatha, and all Maharaj speaking one by one, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, everybody. After that, Paramahansa Jadavar Goswami Maharaj singing song, kirtan very nicely, you know, very, very nicely, you know. After that Acharya asking to Paramahansa Kesava Goswami, you like to speak something? Kesava Goswami has gone mad. You call me to speak. What is this question? You call me to speak. Now you are asking me, you like to speak something. What is that? Now be careful. Actually, there is so many gentlemen here. Actually, you know, big, you know, high court judge. You know, everybody there. Be careful about speaking. Kesava Goswami is laughing, smiling. After that, starting Vandana and speaking Harikatha and speaking so heavily. That all these, you know, high court judge and everybody, all, you know, honored guests, they become shocked. They were very shocked. They feel, you know, they're feeling heavy this way. So anyway, those who are going to follow Prabhupada in, you know, those who are going to follow Prabhupada 100%, they cannot change their Siddhanta, Mati, anything. Because they are not speaking Harikatha to get anything. Those foolish society, they are so foolish, they don't understand that if that Maharaj is going to speak in a very favorable way, they can enjoy popularity, they can get so much pranami, so much honor, but they are going to ignore all these things and they are going to speak about the Absolute Truth. What a kind of big sacrifice! Even in this kind of sacrifice, we cannot compare with a freedom fighter. Though he is going to give his life, but he cannot give his mind totally. The fallacy, many questions coming to me from different parts of the world. Freedom fighter, they are going to give body, but 100% mind they cannot give. Not possible. Maybe some shortage is 1%, 2%. They are going to give life to get reputation, pratishtha. I told you that, na? Who is going to speak? I am not ready to get any pratishtha. I am less interested. Who is speaking is lie. Even freedom fighter is also going to get pratishtha. Without pratishtha, nobody going to do anything. Nobody. So only that. The only difference is that Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, they are interested about Vaishnavi Pratishtha, they are interested about material Pratishtha. These are different. This is the difference, not heaven and hell difference. Infinity difference. How and when they can make up their mind with pure Guru Vaishnava. That's why sometime we are speaking this sloka, Jasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarvaguna istatra shama sati suraha haru avaktasya kuto mahadguna manorathena sato dhavato vai. Jasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarvaguna istatra shama sati suraha haru avaktasya kuto mahadguna manurathin asato dhavato vahi. We cannot compare a Vaishnav and his transcendental quality with anybody in this world. We cannot compare the transcendental quality of a Vaishnav with any man in this whole world. People are so foolish, they cannot distinguish the difference. They are so foolish, they cannot understand what is Shuddha Bhakti, what is the difference between Shuddha Bhakti and Mayavad. Actually, they are less interested. They like to think about their position, rank, glamour. they are going to join one spiritual party or any spiritual organization simply because they are interested to get some glamour, position, status. This much. You know, Srila Jiva Goswami was speaking that if somebody coming in Gauriya Math for a long time, maybe for 10 years past, but is not feeling, is not going to feel any necessity to take shelter of a Sadguru. The Tathavid Acharya speaking, his coming to Gauriya Math is useless, has no actual meaning. He is coming here because he is showing that he is doing some satsanga to get some glamour and position in society so that people cannot have any doubt about this. That man is very honest. He is going to Gauriya Math daily. Really? Yes. He is doing daily to hear Harikatha, Kirtan, morning time, Arati. Come on. He is a businessman. He is going to collect his Pratishtha. Nothing else. Nothing else. How you can understand? Only Gauriya Math can point out. You all are so blind, and I think in infinity period, who is going to give operation to your eyes, to give you a vision, actual vision? Who can give? Merciful Vaishnav, those who are all Guru Varga, they are merciful. Now at present, everybody merciless. They like to cut you. They like to cut your pocket. A cheater. They are not going to show exact way of devotion, bhakti. So they are actually, Prabhupada speaking, you know, it is called, it is not actually jivadaya. It is mercilessness. They are going to cheat you. This way, they are going to get some jivahimsa. They are going to do some jivahimsa. Because they are well aware about the point that Prabhupada speaking this way, we should speak this way, but we cannot speak this way. Many of those, you know, acharyas and many of those, you know, important sannyasis, they are speaking, you know, if we are going to follow Prabhupada, we cannot run Gauriya Math. I think he should be isolated from Gauriya society. He is Mayavadi. He should be isolated instant. Whatever position he is enjoying at present, he should be isolated. Otherwise, you can develop corona also immediately. It's more than corona. You see, why is speaking this way? If we are at all going to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, then we cannot run Gauriya Math. You are not a member of Gauriya Math. 100%. I am sitting in Vyasasana. I can speak. You know, I can take oath. You know, and speak. Not actually Gauriya devotee. Gauriya, actual Gauriya devotee can never speak that way. Can never speak that way. It is not the mood. You know. So you see, we think somebody coming in Gauriya Math for a long time, 10, 20 years, maybe is developing bhakti. Bhakti is not so cheap thing. But you think bhakti is not such a cheap thing so that you can go to market and buy. I give you challenge, go to market. Here, anywhere you go, I give you open license. All you can go anywhere in the world. In Vrindavan, Haridwar, anywhere you go. And show who is going to speak exactly what Prabhupada told. You will have to show me. You will have to show me who is not going to try his best to get Pratishtha. You can show me. Very sweet language, very sweet representation, very sweet dry philosophy. You have no scope to understand, no scope to arrest him. This is a peasant status of Harikatha, Harikirtan. So, Prabhupada speaking, slightest deviation, very small deviation from Shuddha Bhakti can ultimately, you can get place in the lap of Maya Devi. You cannot expect pure bhakti to come. You cannot expect pure bhakti to come in your life with a mixing of maya. We cannot expect Shuddha Bhakti to come in your life with a Maharaj slight mixing. No. You cannot expect Shuddha Bhakti to come in your life with a slight mixing of Mayavad, Maya, impersonalism. You can fall down. Not a matter of joke, pure devotion. Not a matter of joke, try to calculate all every time. Try to rest. Try to take rest unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Otherwise, say, I can challenge. They were not going to get pure devotion. You are not, surely, I am sure that you are not going to get pure devotion. You cannot get. It's not possible. So you see, actually, so slight deviation can put you in trouble. Slight deviation can put you in trouble. So, Paramahansa Kesava Goswami speaking heavily. Guru Varga, those who are in line with Prabhupada, they are speaking this way. So, impersonalism, Mayavad can come in different, all different ways, even you cannot imagine. So, Tattvavid Acharya, our previous Guru Varga speaking, if at all you find somebody coming to Gauriya Math for a long time, not taking initiation, but coming daily, watching Ardhita, maybe he can develop some Sukriti. But maybe that Sukriti is also Bhaganmukhi Sukriti, can give backing in your enjoyment. Maybe this can give some backing in your enjoyment. Because Bhaganmukhi Sukriti and Bhaktinmukhi Sukriti are not the same. He is coming to Math, but he is not going to feel a necessity, and he is not feeling a necessity to take shelter of a Sadguru. That means his coming to Math is false, a show business. Because Rupa Goswami was writing in Rasamrita Sindhu, Adau Guru Padasrayat Asmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. Adau Guru Padasrayo, at all he is not going to take shelter unto lotus feet of Sadguru. No question of starting any pure devotion. His coming to Math is for so. You have to feel urgency. I need Guru. I need Guru. Whenever you get the association of a pure Vaishnava, I mean Shikha Guru, whenever you get the association of a pure Shikha Guru in a Vaishnava, then immediately you can feel some reaction inside your heart. You can feel urgency to take shelter of a Sadguru. Where is Sadguru? Where is Sadguru? Where is Sadguru? You can become mad in search of a Sadguru. If you are not going to feel that way, be sure you are coming to Gauriya Math, you know, going to indicate some other desire. Anna Vilas. What to speak about that? Those who are coming to Gauriya Math for 24 or 25 years, 40 years, 50 years, I heard they are speaking, my life is just spoiled. I come to Gauriya Math life. He cannot speak spoiled. So educated speaking. My life is spoiled. Cannot speak spoiled. I am laughing. This is the member of Gauriya Math. This is the member of Gauriya Math. Eh? If you go through all the Siddhanta of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you can find we are going to give indulgence to some impersonalism. Hey, come to Math. Are, if you have your power, why not to change him? Birds of same feather flocks together. Already they are searching for some enjoyment. No service, no business, no money, nothing there. Then they took decision to come to Gauriya Math. There we can get some scope to enjoy, to get some pratishtha. Very freely, nobody going to fight. Open enjoyment. Prabhupada speaking, we are not going to enter into an agreement. Surely we are not going to enter into agreement with you that come on, we can stay in Gauriya society to enjoy some facility. Nice, you know, prasadam we can cook. Very nice, you know, food we can take. Surely we are not going to enter into any kind of agreement with those foolish men. It is not mess house. Mess, you know, mess body mean, mess house mean, those who are doing service in city, they have no place, they contact one, you know, room, they pay something, or maybe 100 or 150 people, they together they are going to pay the rent of that building, and some Uriya Thakur, Uriya Brahman is there, he is taking all khaini, tobacco, tea, everything, no problem. They can take and going to cook for us. Everybody giving contribution. So after 1 month they calculate how much expenses, they according to they give payment, and after that the fund is maintained by somebody, they are going to maintain. Today you can cook this, tomorrow you can do this, somebody can take rest up to 8 o'clock, after that can go to office. Office is just near. Prabhupada speaking, we are not going to enter into agreement with anybody, just like a mess body, just like a hostel or hotel, that we can arrange, you know, we can arrange all our facility for cooking, staying, fooding and lodging. We are busy with this thing, how much enjoyment they can get, how much, you know, if the higher authority going to speak something, I can throw him, kick him. You are not Vaishnav, otherwise why you are speaking this way? Vaishnav never speak? Yes, Vaishnav never speak. Vaishnav is dumb and deaf, like a foolish acharya. The more you can give material facility, the more you can give boat, they can give boat in favor of you. But Prabhupada speaking, we are not going to enter into agreement with, you know, those, you know, foolish people to arrange our, you know, facility, different kind of facility, not that. So you see, if you are doing some satsanga, the result of satsanga, Jiva Goswami was speaking, the result of satsanga itself is very, very, very powerful. Jiva Goswami was writing, satsanga can never go vain. Jiva Goswami was going to give guarantee, satsanga can never go vain if you are at all going to do satsanga. Satsanga can give you tremendous power. And at all, if you are going to get satsanga in preliminary stage, after getting pure satsanga, 100% you can feel it necessary to take shelter of a Sadguru. If you are not feeling urgency, even if you are not going to search Sadguru, then surely your coming to mat is useless. This Siddhanta is very secret Siddhanta. All the time we should remember this point, we should not forget. All the time we should remember this point, we should not forget. Actually, Prabhupada, you see the difference between Prabhupada and so common acharyas. You can compare how far we are deviated from the track of Srila Prabhupada. Prabhupada never entering into any compromise with anybody regarding Shuddha Bhakti. On the contrary, Prabhupada always speaking, be careful, Prabhupada speaking, in the way of your Hari Bhajan. Prabhupada speaking, in the way of your Hari Bhajan, in the way of your Hari Bhajan, automatically lab, puja, patishtha, kamini, kanchan can come to contaminate your heart. Naturally, it is quite natural. In the way of your Hari Bhajan, it's an automatic factor. In the way of your Hari Bhajan, be sure kamini, kanchan, pratishtha going to contaminate your heart, very shortly coming. But this kind of pratishtha cannot contaminate the heart of pure Vaishnava, like the case of Madhavendra Puripa. Madhavendra Puripa is going to fly from the place, I can take leave, because maybe in the morning time people can come and shout, that he is pure devotee, so I can take leave right now in the midnight. This is the heart of pure devotee. They are less interested about pratishtha. They are less interested about pratishtha, what you like to confer to them. They are less interested about pratishtha. Whenever Prabhupada is speaking Harikatha anywhere, be it in Benaras Hindu University, BHU, even in Benaras Hindu University, which is the you know, original place of Mayavad, Prabhupada giving speech in Benaras Hindu University, by intact way, explaining Vedanta so nicely, no Mayavadi, you know, professor there, they are not going to fight with him. He is giving answers so exclusively. Prabhupada giving answer. Even in Benaras Hindu University, Prabhupada speaking in tact way, not going to change even, you know, dash, hyphen, nothing, no punctuation. Speaking this way. This is actually the Harikatha of Prabhupada. You know, we are in the line of Prabhupada, we must maintain that kind of, you know, bhakti, binodhara. Otherwise, we should take leave, because we can contaminate. In the name of Hari Bhajan, Hari Katha, we can contaminate the whole Vaishnava society. Day by day, those are impersonal Mayavadi, they are coming and joining our Shuddha Bhakti Pratishthan organization to contaminate the whole system. You know, if I go on explaining, I can explain, surely. Then you can understand. Now, first of all, I like to explain that Madan Mohan Malabhya, the great, you know, he was a big pandit. He was just mad. He was just mad after looking. He was just mad to see, to hear the Harikatha of Srila Prabhupada. He told when he came to Gaudiya Mission, Calcutta Gaudiya Math, he told, in my whole life, never I was ready to bow down in front of any acharya. But automatically, my hair, I was bound to bow down unto the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. So great, so unique, Acharya Srila Prabhupada. Not, you know, no contamination, no smell of any contamination in the acharan of Srila Prabhupada. So pure acharan. It is rare, most rare at present. Unique Acharya of Srila Prabhupada. Madan Mohan Malabhya say, in my whole life, who was, you know, bound to speak that way, in my whole life, I never bow down in front of anybody. Only I was bound to bow down unto lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. So big Acharya, so unique Acharya he is. You know, I cannot explain in my word. In my word I cannot explain, you know. So he was very happy to see, in a whole life, you know, he was worshipping the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. Now, what is the preaching system at present? Prabhupada speaking, in the way of Hari Bhajan, automatically, La Puja Patishtha coming to contaminate your heart. Be careful. Hari Bhajaner Anushangik Falsarup, you know, as an ancillary factor of your Hari Bhajan, automatically those La Puja Patishtha can come. You should not be busy all this with all those cheap things. You should not be busy with all those cheap things. You are always busy with Patishtha. You are always busy with Patishtha. La Puja Patishtha. For slight Patishtha, you can wash. You try to wash the name of Gaudiya Math. For slight Patishtha, you like to erase the name of Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. In the name of Pratishtha, you like to erase the name of Gaudiya Math. I know it very well. Ultimately, I can openly show, you know, that Mayavad contamination is there. Yeah. Open truth, naked truth, nobody like to see, a naked truth. But usually we hear from our society, mitam cha saram cha bhaktita, mane bhagmita. Oratorship mean you like to speak in gist, you like to speak to the point, you like to explain all point what you mean to say. That is called oratorship. But that oratorship doesn't mean that you have bhakti. Oratorship doesn't mean that you have bhakti. Maybe you have oratorship, you can speak hours after hours. Baba, that doesn't mean that you have bhakti. Doesn't mean. You cannot even imagine what kind of power was there with Prabhupada. I cannot explain. Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj speaking. Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj, my Guru Pad Padma speaking. That with some of my godbrothers, with some of my godbrothers, I went to Orissa Katak. I went to Orissa Katak Revensha College, Revensha College. My Guru Maharaj also many times went to deliver speech there in Revensha College, Paramahansa Madhava Goswami Maharaj. So that time Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Aranya Maharaj, all the disciple of Prabhupada, all they are going to speak Harikatha in front of all erudite scholar. Important personalities in the society, big professors, you know, and research fellow, speaking Harikatha. Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj, you know, was the sabhapati, you know, of that chairman. So naturally he is going to speak last, and before his speech, he allowed Paramahansa Aranya Goswami Maharaj to speak. Srila Aranya Goswami Maharaj was speaking in such a way about the glory of Gauranga Mahaprabhu's, you know, Gauranga Mahaprabhu's merciful in manner, about the absolute mercy of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Abadan, in an unparalleled Abadan of Sri Chaitanya Dev. He was speaking. After speaking for almost 1 hour, he is going to stop his speech, and Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj, you know, going to conclude with his speech, because it's the last speech. Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj speaking. Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj speaking. My godbrother, Srila Aranya Goswami Maharaj, was speaking this way so in details that his speech is almost complete. So in this last flag end, I don't like to speak for a long time. I like to conclude my speech and speaking something about what Aranya Goswami Maharaj told. Now Srila Kesava Goswami Maharaj speaking. You see the power of Prabhupada. All professors there, all research fellow there, they are standing and giving honor to Aranya Goswami Maharaj. They are clapping heavily, because this kind of unique philosophy they never heard in their life. And after that, they are making some inquiry that in what subject that Aranya Goswami Maharaj has done doctorate. Has some doctorate on some topics. Which that topic is? Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj laughing. Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj laughing and going to speak in front of us. You see the power of Prabhupada. You see the power of Prabhupada. What kind of power is there with Prabhupada that even illiterate man can speak like a pandit? Even illiterate man can speak like a big pandit. Even big pandit cannot find any fault with them. Now you can conceive, you can realize the power of Prabhupada. Srila Bhanu Goswami Maharaj there in England, and Prabhupada giving power from here. Srila Goswami Maharaj there in England, Prabhupada giving power from here. You cannot imagine. That kind of power. Pangung langhai the giving, pangung langhai the grim. You can speak dry philosophy, but I can prove that 100% you cannot believe. You cannot believe 100% under a lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma. You cannot prove. You cannot prove 100% submission under the lotus feet of your Guru Pad Padma. But you are speaking. Agyana Tibiranda Sagana. You are speaking this way. But you cannot prove. Kesava Goswami is speaking, this kind of power, our Gurudev was so powerful that even people can think that those who are illiterate, even big pandit can think they have done some doctorate on some topics. Actually, Aram Maharaj cannot write properly. Aranya Goswami Maharaj cannot write properly, but this kind of power was there in him. That is the excellency of Prabhupada, the Acharya Siddhi. You try to understand. You try to understand and try to see the present situation. Even they are going to throw Hari Bhakti Vilas, they like to throw Rasamrita Sindhu. They want to prove we are more merciful Acharya. So we are not going to consider all these factors. They like to ignore the instruction of Rupa Goswami Pad. They like to ignore the instruction of Srila Sanatana Goswami Pad. They like to ignore the instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. So great they are. So great they are Acharya Siddhi. They like to throw everything. They like to make some new rules and regulation. Prabhupada speaking, be careful man. In the way of Hari Bhajan, it's an automatic factor that you are going to get some love, puja, patishta, but don't try to think that people going to give honor to you. Same way, many of our Guru Varga manifesting this kind of leela. They are totally deviated from Prabhupada. They actually fall down. They are deviated from the track of Prabhupada, lotus feet of Prabhupada. They are trying to project who is Gauriya Math, who is Prabhupada. I am all. Preliminary state they are okay. But after that they become bhakta. They want to prove that we are all. You know, you can go through their life history. If you don't believe, if you go through their life history, you can find their last end. You can find their painful end. Then you can find that they are all against Gauriya Math and against Prabhupada. You can easily understand. They are going to get this kind of punishment. So nobody can survive. Nobody can survive. Not a single man who is committing apraha unto a lotus feet of Gauriya Math and Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Bhaktivinoda Thakur and a Gauriya Guru Varga. If they like at all, they like to project themselves. But shortly, this foolish society someday can understand, all false. Their siddhanta all wrong. Their philosophy all false philosophy. Only they wanted to misguide us. Then they wanted to put some screen in front of our eyes so that we cannot see that absolute truth. That was their target. So this way actually, Prabhupada speaking, in the way of Hari Bhajan, Hari Katha, automatically we are going to get La Puja Patishtha. Always try to think that all La Puja Patishtha, anything coming in my life, I cannot touch because I am going to accept only Vaishnavi Patishtha. I should pass on all Pratishtha, all glamour, what all you are giving to me. Even garland, pranami, be sure, with full commitment I am speaking. We'll have to serve Gauranga Dev. We have no right to enjoy. We have no right to enjoy. We cannot, prove that Prabhupada is nothing. I am all. Cannot prove. So this way actually, in course of your Hari Bhajan, it's an automatic factor. In the way you can get it off. So, Prabhupada speaking, don't be busy with all those very small things. Always and every time try to understand, try to realize that your life is unstable. Each and every fraction of second, you try to realize that life is unstable. Anytime we can go away from this material world. Any time we can go away from this material world. So don't be busy with lab, puja, patishtha. Try to be clever, real, in true sense. Try to understand this point. Because in Shastra 7th canto we know, in Bhagavatam 1 slope, the kala karma guna dhino deho ayam pancha bhautikaha katham anyamstu gopayet sarpagrasto yatha jayaparaha. Kala karma guna dhino deho ayam pancha bhautikaha kala karma guna dhino deho ayam pancha bhautikaha katham anyamstu gopayet sarpa gusto yaya para. Just like a snake going to catch one frog, you know, frog is always barking. Gyao, 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 gyao. Arey, stop your face. If you are going to bark, if you are going to, you know, speak, gyao, gyao, then those snake, they can get clue that there is one food, there is one, you know, frog. Again, they are going to catch you. Why not you stop? But he is going, you know, unnecessarily gyao, gyao, gyao speaking. So now it is this example. Karma kalo karma guna dhino diho ayam panch bhautikaha. All your kal mean time, circumstances, your activities, your body, everything, all is controlled by some unknown force. All is controlled, you have no controlling. You have no controlling over your body, over your mind, over your, you know, property, over your, you know, nothing. You have no controlling. Try to understand. Kal karma gunadhino. Kal karma, maya, ishwar, all Vedanta Sutta, all those very vital points. Vedanta Sutta dealing with all those vital points. Kalaha, karma, you know, maya, jagat, ishwar, all dealings, you know. So, kala karma gunadhin, kala karma gunadhinu dehoyam pancha bhautikaha. Your body is made up of khiti apatejmadbha, five elements of this nature. So, you have nothing. You have nothing in your life. You have nothing in your life, so that you can claim that this building is my building, this body is my building, this is my wife, this is my husband. You have no right to speak. Because you have no controlling over your own body. So how you can speak? Whereas you have no controlling over your own body, how you can speak that way? You know. So you have no controlling over even your own body and mind. So how you can take control over this whole universe? Prabhupada speaking, those who are going to get control over this society, this can prove to be a big bondage in their life. This can be a big bondage in their life. We are busy to collect, you know, different kind of degrees and everything. We are always busy to collect different, because if I can collect some degrees, then I can write Vedanta Acharya, I can write Shastri, I can write this, that, Falana, I can write this and that. But Prabhupada in his whole life, he was the topmost Pandit in this whole world. But never Prabhupada wanted to collect some degrees. Prabhupada never tried in his life to collect some degree. At present we are busy with degree. If somebody is going to confer this on behalf of Vishwavaishnava Sabha, there are different kind of degree that were aprakita degree. Those degrees are not prakita material degrees. Prabhupada used to speak. Prabhupada used to give Vidya Vinod or Maha Upadeshak, Maha Mahapadeshak. Different kind of, you know, title, you know, Prabhupada used to confer them. This is called Vaishnavi Pratishtha, not material Pratishtha. But in whole life, Nobody can prove that people Prabhupada wanted to collect Patishtha, glamour, degree, nothing. I also, many people suggested me, Maharaj, you can easily take degree in Vedanta, this, that. I said, no, I am murkha. I am illiterate. How I can get degree? I have no right to take any degree. Bhaktivinoda Thakur never wanted to write Bhakti Bhushan, this, that, you know. But he is the topmost pandit. You know, Gauranga Mahaprabhu wanted to, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, even Supreme Lord, want to give them, always want to give them some title. Like Haridas Thakur, when gone, Mahaprabhu going to give full patishtha to Haridas Thakur. Full patishtha to Haridas Thakur, Mahaprabhu is ready, dancing with the body, and going to Haridas Chila Mahabhagavat. When Haridas gone, ho Prithivi, ho world, Dharati Devi, you are going to miss one jewel. Mahaprabhu going to give big title to Haridas Thakur. Mahaprabhu speaking, you know, in front of sea, ocean, you know, sea, ocean, speaking, now you are going to clean, you are going to wash, now today you have the scope to clean, to wash, you have the chance to wash the lotus feet of Haridas Thakur. So now you become a great pilgrimage. Now today, you are growing a big power, because today you are going to wash the lotus feet of Haridas Thakur. So you see, Mahaprabhu himself going to give, confer a big degree. Those devotees, they are less interested about your... They never want to collect title. Vedanta Acharya, you know, Bhakti Bhushan, Bhagavata Acharya, they never like to. Now at present we can discover how far we are deviated from the track of Srila Prabhupada. How far we are deviated from the track of Prabhupada. How far we are deviated from the lotus feet of Prabhupada. 100% faith we should have unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord and His devotee like Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada. Then and only then we can discuss about the unique Acharya Srila Prabhupada. Otherwise we can fear. If I am going to discuss this way, people can indicate, Maharaj, you are discussing this point, but you have your loophole. You have some defects in your life. Under the guidance of Prabhupada, we are putting open request to whole world. Those who can detect even one fault, then we can pay dandavat unto their lotus feet. Like usually, in publication field, I mean especially in, you know, book market, we know this. Suppose big important books are going to be published by some company. And some who is the writer, who is the editor, very important thing. After all, that company going to give responsibility to big educated man. They are putting challenge. So we are going to give the almost final scripture. I am going to give hand over this final script in front of you. If you can find one defect, you can go through this, you can proofreading. You can make proofreading. If you can make one mistake, then we can give you 50 rupees. Previously it was 10 rupees, 5 rupees, suppose there is some mistake, punctuation, then it indicates. Then the company is bound to give him for each and every defect. Suppose in the whole book there is 500 defects, then multiply with 50 rupees. This way, because it's slip of eyes. If you see the proofreading, maybe some slip. You slip this in online. There is some defect. If you allow another man to look, Maharaj, there is one. This way. some ghost is there. The some ghost is there in publication, you know, field. They cannot allow us to see that there is mistake. This way, actually, those who are pure Guru Vishnu, they are going to put an open request in from the world. If you can kindly point out one defect in my life, please, you can, and then I can rectify my life and I can try to do bhajan properly. But at present, it is the idea, it is the siddhanta of Prabhupada. At present, if I am going to speak something, hey, why are you speaking? You have thousands of defects. Yes, I have thousands of defects. So at present, Harikatha is almost rare. Nobody is going to speak Harikatha. Harikatha means you will have to speak absolute truth. Harikatha is there. But absolute truth they are not going to discuss. Because now the formula Prabhupada speaking, Tumbichu Bhambichu. You can keep silence. I can also keep. I am not going to speak anything about you. And you should not speak anything about letters. This is present formula. But Prabhupada used to speak, Tumbichu Bhambichu. You must keep silence, I must keep silence. But a pure devotee, like I already told many times before, that actually Tulsidas ji Maharaj, some devotee speaking, Maharaj, so-called devotee speaking, Maharaj, that man, that sadhu is always criticizing you, all the time, really so, yes, you don't know? No, I heard, but then I can make one bhajan kutir, I can make one nice bhajan kutir in front of my bhajan kutir. Are you don't understand what I mean to say. What? Actually that man, that sadhu always criticizing you, that is why I am going to request that you, I can request you that you bring that sadhu. I can beg and make one, you know, very nice bhajan kutir in front of my bhajan kutir. So he can go, I cannot see my own fault. Bonded soul can never find. Actually, Tulsidas ji is not bonded soul. Prabhupada is not bonded soul. Bhaktivinoda Thakur. But so many people can find so much fault with Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. At present in Vrindavan. Big, you know, they are pandit, they are one to pull. Bhaktivinoda Thakur not right. And this new Siddhanta they are speaking. With chappal we will have to beat them on their face. And nobody there, all backbone. Oh, Acharya, they are backbone gone. There is no backbone. They cannot come with full challenge. Why you are putting this? Oh, okay, let them speak. We are great Vaishnav. We should not speak anything again. Are, that's why I told many times before. Even in Open Sabha in Chandigarh also, Machkola, there I told. With the help of this undue advantage, we cannot take undue advantage of this sloka. Kaimone vakye kare udvigna divo. We cannot take undue advantage of this sloka and stop speaking about the absolute truth. Be careful. Because then Gauranga Mahaprabhu is there already there inside my heart as Paramatma, going to arrest me. Whole world can give garland to me. Thousands of lakhs of people can take initiation from me. Thousands of people can take initiation from me. Thousands of people can watch my Harikatha over internet. How many subscribers? Maharaj, more than 1 lakh. Are more than 1 lakh subscribers? That doesn't mean it is Harikatha. Because it is at all Harikatha, then you cannot find even a single subscriber in the world. If there is genuine Harikatha, whole world can go against you. And nobody can allow you to speak in any mode. Any mode they cannot allow. And first point Prabhupada wanted to speak, until and unless there is 100% Saranagati. Until and unless there is 100% Saranagati unto the lotus feet of Sadguru, Bhagavan, you have no right to speak about that absolute truth. It is not drama. In a drama, you can find somebody, you know, going to make suicide, somebody going to, but there is no reality. There is no genuinity. It is drama. So our sannyas base, our acharya base, our, you know, paramahansa base, all not for drama giri. We are not going to show some drama in front of whole world. If there is no genuinity, 100% sure we are going to get punishment. Prabhupada told, I am not speaking. Prabhupada told, surely they are going to get punishment, 100%. The number of, you know, those who renounce order are increasing day by day. I mean, they are going to enter into the team of Ravan. They want to enter into the team of, you know, Ravan. They want to enjoy their life in the uniform of sadhu. So much thing, Mayavad, impersonalism, cunning is so different way. If I, you know, whole life if I discuss, still I cannot fit so vast chapter. So I can surely touch one by one to prove the unique Acharya Jiva of Srila Prabhupada. Long ago, I want to cite one example. If you are going to believe, if you are going to believe Sadguru, if you are going to believe Bhagavan, then nobody can make any problem in your life. Nobody can make any problem in your life. If you are 100% inclined, if somebody is going against you, they can die. They can come, because at present this is the situation. If they are not going to tally, if they are not going to harmonize their vichar, their mind and heart with Gurudev, they are going to take leave. First of all, non-cooperation. Non-cooperation. After that, competition. Competition. First of all, non-cooperation. When they are going to take, you know, leave from Guru Vaishnava Seva. First of all, they can show non-cooperation mood. After some day, they can open competition. After some day, they can show open fighting with Guru Vaishnava. Like in the life of Prabhupada, you can see so many disciples of Sri Prabhupada. They are all against Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Not actually against Prabhupada, mainly. They want to prove, you know, they are not going to quote the name of Prabhupada. Kesava Goswami is speaking. We are less interested about his argument. He has written one new book, Achinta Vedavet Bhat. We are less interested about that. First of all, we like to know who is his guru. Shubhat Saha, who is his guru? First we like to know. Without Guru Kripa, he like to write books. To prove that Gaudiya Math book is all false. That same man, he was bound to write one nice book under the guidance of Prabhupada, by the Kripa of Prabhupada. Now he is going to cut his own Siddhanta, because that was published from Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math, and now it is being published from another organization. They are going to publish. This way, we are totally deviated from the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada. We are, for simple Pratishtha, we can sell our Bani Vaibhav, library, Bani Vaibhav, all we can sell to Mayava, the impersonalist. We can sell it, because I can get Pratishtha. Newspaper man, media can come and take a photo and give in newspaper that this Acharya Maharaj going to give this library in donation to this society. And what is the truth? What is the fact? If you know the fact, then you can go mad. They want to, for a little Pratishtha, they can sell Bani Vaibhav, Vaishnav, they can kill Vaishnav also. This is their status. So, I was in Suryakunda long ago, because situation was that, where to go? I have no place to go. In Suryakunda, there, midday Leela of Radha Govinda there. So I was doing, you know, writing something, doing some seva there, and doing And speaking Harikatha, but they are Brajavasis, they cannot understand Harikatha. Those were village Brajavasis at present. Brajavasis mean those eternal, you know, parshad of Radha Govind. But actually those who are staying in Braja, they don't understand Gaudiya Siddhanta. Each and every fraction you will speak, what? They can speak. So I feel very disgusted to speak Harikatha. But still I am speaking. One or two Gaudiya devotees there speaking Harikatha. One day, after Harikatha is over, when I stand up, because when my coping and Bahirvas is already there, I am feeling some problem inside my coping. I am speaking Harikatha, I cannot open, it's big problem. After that, when Harikatha is over, and I stand, then one scorpio just fall down from my vasasana and from my cloth. Everybody surprised. Where is the scorpio? The scorpio was there inside my, just beside my kopi. I was wondering. Now some devotee was wondering, just speaking, how it is possible? Wherever if you touch a scorpio, they can going to bite you. But whereas you are speaking Harikatha, that day specially was discussing about Nrisimhadeva and Prahlad Maharaj. I wonder. I was bound to believe. How really? I am discussing about Nrisimhadeva and Prahlad Maharaj. Oh, so merciful Nrisimhadeva. It was just almost inside my coping, but not doing any harm to me. Oh, from that day, my faith, you know, increasing double. So, also I am putting request in front of all devotees all over the world. If there is any defect, if there is hundreds of defect in me, I like to know. I like to rectify myself. I like to become a real sadhu. I promise and speak, I like to become a real sadhu. I am not sadhu. I like to become a real sadhu. You know, this way. So, actually, point is that we have no controlling over your sense organ, mind, body, nothing. Only we can shout like dog. This much power I have, money power, man power, educational power, you know, I can speak, I can shout like a dog, but I cannot get actual power of bhajan. I cannot get, until unless I am 100% inclined unto lotus feet of my Sadguru, until and unless I am 100% inclined unto lotus feet of Sadguru, I cannot get power. Who is going to pass this kind of remark? Prabhupada speaking. Who is going to pass this kind of remark that he is Vaishnav, he is not Vaishnav? He is Vaishnav and he is not Vaishnav because he is not going to, you know, allow me to do all nonsense. That's why he is not Vaishnav. Present situation. So you see how far, how much we are deviated. You know. At the time of Prabhupada, it was the general rule that those are competent personality, big, big spiritual personality, we can make chairman of his sabha. At present, we are going to enjoy vote. That marriage is very, you know, important, you know, is going to here and there, very huge amount of money, position. So we can make him, you know, chairman of his sabha. Idiot people. This is the situation. They know nothing. They know nothing about bhajan. Not even wa kakha. You know, a kakha, a, b, c, d of bhajan. They are going to pass this kind of remark. He is Vaishnava. Gaur Kasipa Bhaj Maharaj is not Vaishnava. He is Vaishnava. He is Vaishnava. He is not Vaishnava. Are who give you power? It is the sabha of Kamsa. In the sabha, in the assembly of Kamsa, automatically, in the assembly of Kamsa, Chanur, Mustik, Putana, Bakasu, they are going to get honor. What wrong in it? In the sabha of Kamsa, we cannot expect. In the sabha of Kamsa, we cannot expect that Vasudev can be mega chairman. On the contrary, they can kill Vasudev. Hey, big! Vasudev, I can put Vasudev in chain, in jail. This is the situation. You know, Vrindavan, in Vrindavan there is one very, very nice humor. You know, there is one nice, those big sadhu they are speaking. Maharaj, ऊँटों की सभा में गीदर गायन है, या तो गीदर का सभा में ऊँट गायन है. ऊँट जानते हो, कैमल. इन द असेंबली ऑफ जैकल दैट कैमल कैन गेट द चांस टू सिंग ए नाइस सॉन्ग. यू नो, तुम बिचू हम बिचू, ओके, यू कैन कन्फर सम टाइटल टू मी. आई कैन ऑल्सो, आई कैन स्पीक गोस्वामी टू यू. You can also speak Goswami to me. Mutually we can. It's a question of mutual adjustment. We can make nice adjustment. But Prabhupada like to, throw all this kind of assembly. So in the assembly of Kamsa, we cannot expect, Vasudev ji can be given a nice, position. It's quite natural. So this is the situation at present. Who is going to pass this kind of remark? That he is Vaishnava, he is not Vaishnava. Who give you power? My Guru Maharaj give me power to. He make me Acharya. That doesn't mean you are Acharya. Maybe your Guru Maharaj cheat you. Your Guru Maharaj making you Acharya. There is no other way. To stop the breakdown of the society, okay. At present, we should take resolution that nobody can act as Acharya. Nobody. Until and unless we can prove that we are in the line of Prabhupada. But who is going to give judgment? Bhaktivinoda Thakur is not there. Prabhupada is not there. That is why Prabhupada never wanted to show this voting system. Prabhupada ne bhagwasani, if I am going to make, because maybe there is a nice, sadhu, but if I make this system, they can make one system. So Acharya is an automatic selection, can be done, self-manifested. So you see, suppose Gurudev, before he is leaving his body, going to make somebody Acharya, due to some time and circumstances you are bound to make. But that doesn't mean I am Acharya. Like Bhaktivala Tita Goswami. We can get the example of Bhaktivala Tita Goswami. He never used to speak, I am not Acharya. I cannot accept Acharya. I am not Acharya. My Guru Maharaj give me responsibility to run this society this way. Anyway, if there is one society, they should keep balance between the spiritual world and material world. At present, the tendency to keep balance is, more high frequency. They like to keep balance with material world, not spiritual world. I know when material society can give no benefit to us, but still we are making some society to keep balance. What kind of balance? Doesn't mean to compromise. Balance means, so that we can preach Harikatha properly, make some segregation, society delegation of authority, that we can do. And if we are not going to follow Prabhupada 100%, then that society may be a big society, but still that big society with big society cannot prove that he is successful in his mission. Because successful in his mission means, Prabhupada speaking, what is our mission? Prabhupada, no Acharya in the world told. What is the duty of Gaudiya Math? To erase the current pervading tide of this, this fanatic world is a seemingly unpleasant duty of Gaudiya Math. We cannot allow you to go wrong way. If you like to leave me, you can leave me. I am less interested. But you cannot expect wrong siddhanta from me. You cannot expect. Because I like to give you a reminder. Long ago, maybe 1 or 2 months before, I was bound to discuss this point. Again, I can discuss. because today I think time cannot permit. Vyasadeva Goswami giving this argument in front of Naraji Maharaj. Narad, I am going to speak all this Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, Bhagavad Dharma, Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan in front of you. That doesn't mean you can go and preach. You keep preaching. That doesn't mean you can run here and there and preach, you know, like a madman. That doesn't mean you can, you know, start your preaching like a madman, you know, crazy man. You should follow in toto what I told you, you know, so that all those common people, they can develop bhakti unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan. If I am going to make a different society, if I am going to arrange my rules and regulation in such a way, so that each and everybody going to lose faith in Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta, how nice society formation I have done. I am a traitor. Eh? So that nobody can know the name of Prabhupada. It's very good for me. This is my position of preaching. Preaching can never be done by a common man, so-called devotee, until and unless he is going to enjoy full kippa of Guru Vishnu. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, I can open article and show. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, don't go for preaching. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, don't go for preaching now. Don't go for preaching. Now go on, you know, doing seva under the guidance of pure Guru Vishnu. Don't go for preaching. If you go right now, if you go, you have no sense control. Controlling over your sense organ and mind, if you go for preaching, you can make contamination garbage. Bhaktivinoda, don't go for preaching. No. If you like to preach in future, but presently you will have to preach in front of yourself. You have to preach in front of yourself. To preach in front of yourself, you have to mean, that's mean. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to speak? You will have to speak directly. You will have to speak directly without any duplicity. You will have to speak directly without any duplicity with your real self. Follow. You have to speak with your mind. Dushtamon tumi kisher Vaishnava, Prabhupada speaking. Dushtamon tumi kisher Vaishnava. You are Vaishnava, you want to become a guru, you want to go for preaching in foreign country, you want to prove that you are a great Vaishnava? Don't do that. Dushtamon tumi kisher Vaishnava. Patishyarase, tava harinam keval Krishna, kaita. Pratishtha ase, to collect pratishtha, tava harinam keval Krishna. If you are going to do bhajan, harinam, very secretly, in a solitary castle, Patishtara tare nirjana ghare tava harinam keval kaita. Prabhupada wanted to prove that one real Gaudiya devotee, all the time their musical instrument there inside their heart, always playing musical instrument, always playing in the same tune as played by previous Acharyas, all the time same tune. You'll have to adjust one main, song going on, and if you're going to play your music random, then you are going to break that, rhythm. So same way, you have to feel how you can make a set rhythm with Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur and all Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Guru Bhargava. That we will have to point out. If you are if you are with false ego, then never you can find your fault. It is our duty to point out faults inside their heart. If we can detect and eliminate, then we can become sadhu. Now, Pitamaha Brahma speaking in front of Narad. Narad, you like to speak Harikatha, but be careful. You like to speak Harikatha in such a way so that all common people, they can grow their bhakti unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord Krishna. Yatha haru bhagavati ninam bhaktir bhavishvati. Sarvatmani akhila dhari iti sankalpo varnayu. What? Brahma speaking? Yatha haru bhagavati ninam bhaktir bhavishvati. Sarvatmani akhila dhari iti sankalpo varnayu. With this resolution, you can go to preaching field. With this resolution, that you can arrange perfect benefit for common people. You can give bhakti, you can inculcate bhakti inside their heart. Otherwise, don't go. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already wanted to prove in Chaitanya Charitamrita. It is written there in Chaitanya Charitamrita that if there is no bhakti, then you cannot preach. If there is no bhakti, bhakti is the shakti. If there is no bhakti, how we can preach? If there is no bhakti, then you cannot go for preaching. Bhakti is the shakti. I can discuss all the point, and one by one, I can try to prove, but it depends upon your mercy, all your lotus feet. I pray you bless me so that I can remember everything. Sometimes I forget, you know. One by one, I can go on giving argument that what is impersonalist, what is impersonalism, how we can detect. Many time in course of my editing job, this that I am doing, then somebody in front of me, I am speaking this kind of harikatha continuously, because one day actually, one by one you will have to understand this for a long time. If you go on hearing that what is impersonalism, what is Shuddha Bhakti, maybe in future if you are out of Maya, you can digest all Siddhanta. Now nobody can make fool of you. Nobody can cheat you. One day actually, one very educated man is going to join Gauri Mission. And Prabhupada was there in, that day, especially that day, that, that man coming to join Gauri Mission, but there is Anna Vilas, usually Prabhupada used to test them. It was the system of Prabhupada. First of all, Prabhupada used to put them in testing. It was the usual system of Prabhupada. Prabhupada used to put them in testing. If they are going to pass and come out successful, then Prabhupada was ready to give Harinam, Diksha, anything. Prabhupada was very tough. At present, we are going to throw Haribhakti Vilas and, Rasamrita all into Ganga. Useless. We are more merciful than previous Guru Bhargava. We want to, you like to take Diksha, you can come. Making one garbage, increasing the number of demons, there is a system going. Until and unless we are going to get control over the situation, never in coming hundreds of years, pure devotion is really impossible. If we can take resolution, touching Nishingadev, touching Salagram, that I am not ready to make any mistake. I am not going to arrange my personal pratishtha. Whole world can take resolution. Then we can show the mood of Prabhupada, unique Acharya Seva Prabhupada, and what was done by so-called Acharyas, and how you can protect yourself. Because at present, you like to throw yourself in the flow of Maya. one flow of Maya, eternal, you know, Maya is also eternal. You can fight with me, Maharaj, Maya is eternal, yes, Maya is also eternal. If Bhagavad Shakti is eternal, then Maya, you will have to take it granted. That, you know, that Antaranga Shakti eternal and Bahiranga Shakti is also existence. But you cannot see, sometimes you cannot see. Second or sometimes, because when creation is not there, total creation gone, then all Shakti inside Prabhu. In that case, you cannot discover. But when this creation coming in front of you, again new creation, then you can discover. I can go through Bhagavad and show how Naradi Maharaj speaking about his previous life, this, that. So you see, this way, creation, new creation going, again demise, even going to, you know, destroy by Sankarsan, again new creation. You know, this way, Brahmaji, you know, bhakti shakti bina nahi, bhakti bina nahi, bhakti bhava, kipa shakti bina nahi, bhakti bhava tam. Kipa shakti mane, bhakti, without the kipa of Bhakti Devi, one cannot go for preaching, one should not go for preaching. What preaching you can do? So I can open all the Siddhanta Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, I can show you so that you have no scope to fight with me. So, what, you know, Pitamaha Brahma speaking, Jatha Haru Bhagavati, Jatha Haru Bhagavati Nenam Bhaktir Bhavishvati, Bhaktir Bhavishvati, surely, so that they can get Bhakti. Don't try to misguide them, don't try to misguide them, don't try to make them blind in the name of Acharya Sip. Try to open the screen. Try to discover your naked picture. Try to throw all duplicity from your heart. Then we can bring back the situation or lost for hundreds of years. Lost. 100 years. Going to lose everything. You know? So, yatha haru bhagavati ninam bhaktir bhavishvati sarvatmane akhila dhare iti sankalpo varnai. You will have to speak harikatha. You will have to do harinam sankirtan, but with a strong resolution that anyhow you are not going to make any compromise with those impersonalists. You are not going to make any compromise with, you know, Maya, nothing. You have to take resolution, first of all. If you are not going to take resolution, then anytime you can, you know. So, anyway, if you are shouting, you are going to pass lecture, we have, suppose I have no direct realization, in that case, suppose I have no direct realization, in that case, any amount of preaching done by me is almost useless. Because I have no direct realization. Preaching means you will have to inculcate your feelings. And that's why whenever we hear Harikatha from a pure Vaishnava, whenever we come in front of a pure Vaishnava, our heart melt off. Why? If there is no aparad, if there is aparad, Prabhupada speaking, if there is aparad inside the heart, if Prabhupada speaking this Siddhanta, if there is, I can discuss this point next day, if there is aparad inside our heart, then we can hear Harikatha from big Vaishnava, but still it cannot show result. We can hear Harikatha from big Mahamaha Bhagavat, but still if there is aparad inside heart, that Harikatha cannot get any result. And Jiva Goswami Baba already wanted to prove that actual sadhusanga can never go vain. Jiva Goswami Baba giving example. Knowingly or unknowingly, if you are going to get some satsanga, like the case of that Vaishnav Das, who was originally from Varanasi, who came in front of Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj in Gadroom. Knowingly or unknowingly, because that Vaishnav, pure Vaishnav singing श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवास आदि गौर भक्तबिंद ही इज प्लेइंग ऑन हिज कार्थल एंड सिंगिंग नोइंगली अनोइंगली पर्पसली और विदाउट एनी प्रॉब्लम ही वॉज बाउंड टू हियर दैट ट्रांसेंडेंटल साउंड वाइब्रेशन एंड ही वॉज बाउंड टू फील सम रिएक्शन इन साइड हार्ट एंड दैट रिएक्शन आफ्टर दैट सत्संग He couldn't realize that it was actual satsanga. He couldn't realize that it was actual satsanga. And that due to that satsanga, he was ultimately bound to throw all his glamour, position, acharyaship in Mayavad society and come into Navadvip and searching for a Sadguru. Taking bath in Ganga, and in Navadvip he is traveling here and there, ultimately coming in Gadrum Dham, coming in front of Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj. Now he is successful because his demand was 100% perfect. So he is successful to get satsanga. So you see, knowingly or unknowingly, Jiva Goswami was speaking, if you are going to drink poison, you don't know, unknowingly, you are going to, you know, poison. Long ago, maybe 5 years back, I was in Vrindavan, Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj, there, mutt. Long time before, maybe 18 years back, I was regular speaker, Harikatha, daily. After that, due to some reason, I was bound to stop my Harikatha, because nobody can digest this kind of Harikatha. What to do? So the case I am speaking one point, that if you are going to take poison unknowingly, what to do? Poison is going to show its result. Jiva Goswami Badvi, in front of me, this thing happened. I was there inside a room of in charge. I was after Harikatha is over. My Harikatha was over. I was standing in the room of that, in charge. It was office. And I am going to take leave because I have Harikatha in my own mutt, Dauji Mandir. Because that was Ramnavami Day. Ramnavami Day especially, I get chance to speak 3 times, usually. Because morning time I speak about Srila Bhaktivala Tirtha Goswami Maharaj appearance day. And noon time speaking Harikatha in my mutt, Dauji Mandir, about, you know, Bhakti, you know, Ashram Maharaj is a disciple of Prabhupada. Bhakti Shaudha Ashram Maharaj, because there is a disappearance day. After that, in the afternoon time, I am speaking Harikatha about Ramchandra. So 3 times, I am getting chance 3 times to speak Harikatha. So Bhagavan, by the blessing of that day, after Harikatha, I was just standing, because I am not going to take anything, because I cannot wait for a long time. I am going to join Harikatha there in my mutt. In the meantime, one devotee, he is Grihastha, staying in Jaipur. I don't like to name. He is a so-called disciple of Paramdiva Kesava Goswami Maharaj. He is a so-called disciple of Paramdiva Kesava Goswami Maharaj. He is asking for water. And one brahmachari is so idiot, you know, he is speaking, here is water, he saw. But that was actually acid, muriatic acid. It was in drinking bottle. And that man, you know, that devotee, taking the and started drinking. Oh, he started shouting. And after that, he threw into basin. I said, what happened? But that brahmachari idiot is actually muriatic acid. He speak me water, you drink. Oh my God, this in front of me, I have seen. Oh my God. And many such incident I can speak. One grandson is there, is very chanchal, and we love very much. The grandfather love him very much. And in that house one day, the grandson was not there. He gone somewhere with father and mother. And the grandfather doing that, this is the scope. Today I can arrange some poison with very nice fried cutlet or this that. I can mix poison so that I can catch those rat. Rat, no? There is a big problem of big, big rat. They are going to cut all books and papers, everything. So today is the scope. So, you know, grandfather going to put all this cutlet, everything, with mixing with poison there, so that he can catch rat and throw outside. In the meantime, grandfather was inside room, and when yeah, it was not known to him, he couldn't realize. In the meantime, grandson came, and father and mother was there. Again said, "Here, my grandfather, bring nice thing for me." Started eating. Oh my God! After eating, he felt sick. He was taken to hospital. It was too late. He was dead. Grandfather crying like mad. I am the killer of my grandson, but unknowingly. This way, so many incidents we can say. So knowingly or unknowingly, if you are going to get bad association, you know, I mean, you are going to get the association impersonalist, Mayavad, for that I am not responsible. I love you all, 100%, 100%, 100% I love you all. Because you have your power to speak this kind of fire, to see here this kind of fire. I cannot expect people to hear and stand in front of me hearing this kind of Harikatha. So I pay dandavad all unto your lotus feet. So I am very grateful. Because Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, my previous Guru Varga speaking, is paying dandavad unto the lotus feet of all in those who are going to read this book. Shab Sotar Charane Mor Namaskar. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami going to pay dandavad unto the lotus feet of all those who are going to hear this and, you know, read this book, Chaitanya Charitamrita. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is going to pay dandavad unto their lotus feet. Those who are coming, new generation, also Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami also paying dandavad unto their lotus feet. You know, we cannot expect. But this kind of humility, this kind of submission, this kind of humbleness is there. You know, we cannot even imagine, really so. This way, so knowingly or unknowingly, anyhow, if you are going to get asasanga, you will have to get your result. So first of all, it is my duty on behalf of Vishwa Vaishnava Prabhupada, on behalf of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, on behalf of Prabhupada, all our past Guru Varga, Kesav Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, it is our duty to speak about that absolute truth, absolute way. Maybe you are going to reject me. Maybe you like to reject me, you don't like to hear me. Still, I cannot misguide you. That is my resolution in my life. You all can throw myself out of this society. Still, I don't care. Don't bother. So, it is, and also it is your duty to digest all Harikatha and try to understand very, very fine form of impersonalism, this, that, in what. One example today I can give, time cannot permit. Now I have to run and start editing and translating. Show seva, you know. Yesterday my mind was repeatedly going to Radhakund here, there. There, actually, new seva going on. So I am thinking that the man, that devotee is alone. How he can waste money, this, that, you know. Seva, nice seva going on there. So, I can give one example. One day, one very educated man coming from one society, you know, house, from their home, to join Gauriya Mission, and he is staying and taking prasadam, Prabhupada giving him chance to hear Harikatha and Kirtan. After that, Prabhupada can take decision to give Harinam to him or not to give Harinam to him. Now at present, at a time, Harinam, Diksha, red cloth, you know, sannyas, everything, you know, everything. We are sahajya, you know. We have no right to speak that you are sahajya. We have become sahajya. This is the situation. But Prabhupada used to speak sahajya, 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 as to cut by Siddhanta, Harikatha, all the time. So it is our duty to do. One day, Prabhupada is there in Bhajan Kutir, Calcutta Gaudiya Mission, and Prabhupada hearing that devotee, by chance there is nobody, that devotee is going to practice giving Jaikara. Joy, joy, Guru Gauranga Gandharva, this way, Jaikara. After that, he is going to give some Jaikara. Jaikara, this, that. On hearing this Jaikara, Jayadhani, on hearing this Jayadhani, Prabhupada speaking, he is Mayavadi. All devotees coming, pay dandavat. After Aruti is over, everybody coming to pay dandavat to Prabhupada. Prabhupada speaking, who is giving Jayadhani? But that so-called devotee is just coming. Prabhupada, he is Mayavadi. Oh, really? Yes. Very shortly it was detected that he is really Mayavadi. You know, that day I was speaking in front of some devotee who was there inside my room, of editorial room, speaking. Prabhu, by hearing Jayadhani, I can speak he is Mayavadi. You know, in Vrindavan, this kind of Jayadhani, you know, going on, you know. Aaj ki anand ki jai ho, aaj ki anand ki jai ho, this kind of Jayadhani, when I say, is Mayavadi. Apan apan Gurudev ki jai ho, Mayavadi. 100% I can arrest and I can throw him out of Gaudiya Mission, Gaudiya Math. You know, because you are going to make garbage, but I cannot make garbage. Anyway, you are not going to depend upon me, you are going to take decision yourself, you are going to throw Rasamrita Sindhu, you are going to throw Haribhakti Vilas, you are going to take decision that you are a great Vaishnava. So I have nothing to do, only I can shout like a dog in front of you. Now it's up to you whether to accept my Siddhanta Vichar or not, because I am not speaking any personal Siddhanta. I am all discussing about all the Siddhanta of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. Today I like to stop because I have some other seva. Nikhilo bhuvana maya chinna vichinna karti vibhuda bahula vigyam mukti mohanta datri sithilito vidiragara dharadheshadhani vilasatu hidanityam bhakti siddhanta bani. Nikhilo bhuvana maya chinna vichinna karti vibhuda bahula vigyam mukti mohanta datri shithilito vidiragaradharadeshadani vilasatu hidanityam bhakti siddhanta bani. Vancha kalpaturvasya kipasindu vyavacha patitanam pavana bhavishnabhyo namo.